want to sort of offer you a sense of why Dave and I often say that men are the missing ingredient in getting to real gender equity in the workplace. This is a study from Boston Consulting Group. It is one of many studies, but this one I think nicely exemplifies why we say men have got to be in this conversation. This was a large study across multiple companies asking women, is your organization making genuine progress in gender diversity and inclusion? The key variable here in terms of whether women said yes or no turned out to be whether they saw men actively engaged in supporting and promoting equity. When that was true, 96% of women said, yep, my company gets it, we're making progress, versus only 30% of women when they didn't see their male colleagues engaged. So message to men, we have a crucial role to play here.
How can we be better allies? When we did the research for this, and in the words of men who were doing the work and women and what they expected and what they most appreciated in their male allies, it came out in two clusters, two areas of focus. And the first was interpersonal allyship. And interpersonal allyship is just the basic individually, how do you as an individual man show up in the workplace and holding yourself accountable for doing the work around gender equity and supporting gender fairness and justice in the workplace, doing that through collaborative and participative relationships with your female colleagues. And most of the guys talked about this in terms of how this was really the easy part in their eyes of how allyship is looked at. They said the harder part is the second part, and this is the public and systemic allyship. And this is really about not just holding yourself accountable, but holding others accountable and holding my team accountable, my organization, my leaders, my boss. And that really said there was a sense of personal risk and really putting some skin in the game and putting myself out there, because now I'm having to, when I see something, I've got to do something about it.
How do male allies ensure women don't feel they have to reprove themselves upon returning to work from a family leave?
The problem right now is we tend to look at caregiving as an individual responsibility. And I know this is a very US-centric focus, but it's something that we have to get past. We have to get past this. This is not an individual. This is something that is good for families, it's good for organizations, it's good for our country.
Yeah, and Numan, I would just also add, if we're talking about allyship on this issue, this is something men keep secret too often, right? And Dave and I really advocate for men to be loud and public about their caregiving responsibilities at home. Too often, we see colleagues when they have an obligation with a child or something with a family, a school event, these guys sneak out the back door, right? They don't want anyone to see them leaving. Alternatively, I could be very public and say, I've got obligations and commitments that are very important outside of this place, and I'm going to leave loudly and I'm going to let everyone know. When I do that as a senior male, I normalize caregiving, not only for women, but for junior men who are watching.